हेलो एवरीबडी, गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। होप यू आर फाइन देयर। प्लीज़ स्टे सेफ, टेक केयर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ सेंटेंसेस। एक्चुअली टू कम्युनिकेट विद अदर्स वी नीड टू एक्सप्रेस आवर ओपिनियन और वी नीड टू शेयर अवर आइडियाज वाट एवर इट मे बी अकॉर्डिंग टू द सिचुएशन, अकॉर्डिंग टू द पर्पस। सो इन अवर डेली लाइफ we use different kinds of sentences, isn't it? We use to convey our facts, ideas, opinions, sometimes inquiries, sometimes we may request or advice, and sometimes we may express our joy, pain, sorrow, sometimes we express our wish, blessings or curse or whatever it may be. So according to the purpose, according to the situation, we need to communicate with others. And as it is not our mother tongue, English is not our mother tongue. So as it is not our mother tongue, we need to learn the language. If you learn the language perfectly, if you have command, you will have confidence. Otherwise, you may lose your confidence. So for that, today we are going to learn and we are here to clear our doubts in different kinds of sentences. There are 5 kinds of sentences: declarative or assertive. They are the statements like to share the different ideas and opinion. And this sentence take full stop at the end. Next one is interrogative. Interrogative means asking a question. And at last it take the question mark. And the next comes to imperative sentence. Imperative sentence is it is used to express order, request or advice, etc. And it also, imperative sentence also takes full stop after the end. Next is exclamation, exclamatory sentence. And here this sentence is used to express joy, sorrow, sudden feeling. And this takes the exclamatory mark. Next one comes to optative sentence. Optative sentence is that is used to express our wish, blessing or sometimes curse or prayers also. So let me explain these kinds of sentences through the examples. Okay, now come to the topic, kinds of sentences. There are 5 types of sentences in English. They are classified by their purpose. As I told you, there are 5 kinds of sentences. They are classified or they are used according to the situation, according to the purpose. First one is declarative, and it is also known as assertive sentence. It is not only declarative, but also it is known as assertive sentence. As I told you that this is used to express the ideas and opinion. Let us see the definition. They are used to make statements in order to give information, report, events or opinion. Okay, it is used to express information, report, events or opinion. And these sentence take full stop after the end. It ends with full stop. Okay, it ends with full stop. Okay, just like example, Varu was looking at us. This is a statement. Okay, Varu was looking at us. It is a statement. Okay, this sentence comes under the statement. And in the same way, I like fruits and vegetables. This is opinion, isn't it? I like fruits and vegetables. This comes under opinion. We are expressing our opinion. I like fruits and vegetables, or I like chocolates, or I like ice cream, or I like biryani, or I like non-veg. These things comes under opinion. Okay, and there are negative statements also. There is positive as well as negative to express our ideas or whatever it may be in declarative or assertive sentence. Let us see the negative. Sharu was not watching TV. Not watching, see, not. Okay, not watching TV. These 2 sentences are positive and this is negative. ओके. शेरु वॉज नॉट वॉचिंग टीवी. सब्जेक्ट प्लस वर्ब, हेल्पिंग वर्ब प्लस ऑब्जेक्ट. ओके. एंड हियर इन दिस नेगेटिव सेंटेंस, इन दिस नेगेटिव सेंटेंस नॉट इज यूज्ड बिटवीन हेल्पिंग वर्ब एक्सेरी और हेल्पिंग वर्ब और एक्सेरी वर्ब, हेल्पिंग वर्ब और एक्सेरी वर्ब एंड मेन वर्ब. ओके. नॉट इज यूज, नॉट इज यूज बिटवीन हेल्पिंग वर्ब एंड मेन वर्ब. ओके. एंड इन द सेम वे शेरु वॉज नॉट वॉचिंग टीवी. दिस इज पॉजिटिव एंड दिस इज नेगेटिव सेंटेंस. ओके. एंड नाउ कम टू द नेक्स्ट इंटरोगेटिव सेंटेंस. एज आई टोल्ड यू interrogative sentence, they are asked, they are used to express or they are used to ask a question and it ends with a question mark. Let us see. They are used to ask a question or make inquiries. Yes, asking a question or making the inquiries. Yes or no question. Inquiries comes under yes or no question. Let us see. They are two types, yes or no question. Yes, in these interrogative sentences are two types. They are inquiries, that is yes or no question. Next one is WH question. Next one is WH question. Let us see through the example. Does he speak Marathi? See, does he speak Marathi? This is auxiliary verb plus subject plus main verb. Okay, auxiliary verb. This is auxiliary verb. This is subject. This is main verb, isn't it? Auxiliary verb. These are used to the yes or these are the yes or no type. The answer will be yes or no. One word answer. Does he speak Marathi? Yes or no. If yes, yes. If no, no. So, can you solve this problem? This comes under inquiries. This comes under inquiries. Okay, these two questions, yes or no questions, comes under inquiries. Okay, yes or no questions. Okay, this question begins with auxiliary. These questions begins with auxiliary verb. Okay, these questions, these yes or no questions, inquiries begins with auxiliary verb. Auxiliary verb plus subject plus main verb. Okay, auxiliary verb plus subject plus main verb. Okay, next is who is coming to see us today. See, who is coming, this is WH question. Okay, WH question, WH word. Okay, WH plus WH word plus helping verb. Helping verb or auxiliary verb, this is the helping verb or auxiliary verb. See, who is coming to see us today, who is coming. Who is an auxiliary verb. When the question is started with a WH question, WH word, it follows auxiliary verb. Okay, who is coming to see us today, then at last it ends with question mark. Interrogative sentence ends with question mark, whereas declarative sentence ends with full stop. Okay, this ends with full stop and interrogative sentence ends with question mark. Here also question mark. See, question mark. This is compulsory in interrogative sentence. Then, what are you doing? See, what are you doing? Asking, is it? Asking a question. What are you doing? One sentence question. Okay. This interrogative sentence ends with question mark. Okay. Now come to the next imperative sentence. As I told you, imperative sentence. They are used to express request, advice or whatever it may, order or whatever it may be. So let us come imperative sentence. This is used to give order or instructions, request and give advice. See, they are used to express or they are used to give order, instructions, request or advice. Okay, and these imperative sentence, they may be positive or they may be negative. Come here, come here, or don't go there, this is negative. Come here is positive, don't go there is negative. Okay, like that way. Come here, this also in imperative sentence also takes, it also ends with full stop. Okay, and this is come here is order, command. okay? Come here sometimes. Come here, please. What do you think this? That's a request. Come here. This is order or command. But when we express in this manner, come here, please. So this is a request. Okay? This is a request. Please give me some water. Okay? This is a request. Then don't go near the water. This is don't go. This is negative. Okay? Negative sentence. Don't go. Negative advice. Don't go near the water. So negative advice. So in imperative sentence also, the sentence may be the sentence order, command, request or whatever it may be, they may be positive or sometimes they may be negative. But all the sentences, all the imperative sentences ends with full stop. Okay? Next come to exclamatory sentence. Exclamatory sentence. And you all of you know that exclamatory sentence that is used to express sudden surprise, sudden feeling, whether it may be joy, sorrow, pain or whatever it may be. They are used to express surprise, pain, joy, sorrow, etc. For example, hooray, suddenly, isn't it? Hooray, we won the match. Shh, your father is sleeping. Shh, mother is sleeping. Exclamation, it takes exclamation, isn't it? It takes exclamatory. This is exclamation mark. This sentence takes exclamation. Hooray! Exclamation mark. We won the match. Okay? This expresses the joy, happiness. It's a girl. Suddenly surprise. It's a girl. It's a boy. He's a boy. Like that way. So, sudden surprise. Or otherwise, whoosh. Your father or your brother is sleeping. Shh. Suddenly we use this kind of expressions, isn't it? Shh, ah, ho. These are the expressions. It comes suddenly. We can't expect these kind of expressions. Okay? Suddenly it takes place according to the situation, according to the purpose. So these things comes under exclamatory sentence. And in these sentences we use exclamatory marks. Okay? Next is optative sentence. Yes, optative sentence. This is the other sentence where we use to express our wish, blessings or prayers or curse. Curse means sharp. And let us see through the example. Optative sentence, it expresses wishes, prayers, blessings and curses. What are the examples? Good morning, good evening, okay, good night, that is a wish. Okay, wish also, optative sentence, this also takes exclamatory mark. It does not take full stop, it takes exclamatory mark. So, next is may you live long, yes. This is wish. May you live long. May God bless you. Okay? Then, may you go to hell. This is curse. May you go to hell. Narakam. This is curse. May you go to hell. Okay? Next is happy wedding day. Happy anniversary. Okay? Happy birthday. This is wish. Okay? Or otherwise, God save me. That is prayer. God save me. Okay? Like that way. That is a prayer. So all these optative sentences, they end with exclamatory mark. Okay? All these ends with exclamatory mark. Hope you understood. Please practice more and more. To communicate perfectly, we need to learn more and more. And you all of you know that reading, writing, listening and speaking. Four skills are very important to have command on your language. So hope you understood and please practice more and more. Thank you for watching my video. Please like, share and subscribe. See you in the next class.